MLB Network's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Washington Nationals and the New York Mets. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian welcoming you to another edition of Baseball on MLB Network. I'm joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. The staffs for these two teams sure to be a focal point as this series moves along.
You know, I always think pitching and defense are the keys to success in the long run. So as the season gets started, it's going to be really important for this pitching staff to set a good tone. If they can get off on a good foot, it will do a lot for the confidence of the entire ball club.
All right. The stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Jacob DeGrom, a right-hander from Florida, gets the ball as the starter here. Dan, any thoughts?
Jacob DeGrom is just a solid pitcher. He's not overpowering in any sense with any of his three pitches. Good sinking fastball, 93 to 96. Great slider and a really good changeup. What makes him so good? He'll throw all three of his pitches at any time.
Here now is Juan Soto. He will lead this one off today. The 2-2. Sweet. 64 degrees our temperature here at first pitch this afternoon. Ball three. 3-2 now.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
And that misses ball four. So a good battle to begin the ball game today, but the leadoff man will reach first anyway.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Striding in now for the Nats, Trey Turner. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Soto aboard here at first with nobody out. Here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Time to take a look at the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Mike Fillmore.
Hey, you know, D-Roll, Mike Fillmore, he'll give a little bit off the edges, but he gets the respect not only from the pitchers, but from the players because his zone is consistent.
Yeah, as long as he's consistent, Dan, I'm okay with Mike Fillmore's zone. If a pitcher's pounding that zone, he wants to give a little bit off the outer edge, I'm okay with that.
Here he comes again. 1-2. Ball two. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. One there. On to first. Not in time as he just hits the bag ahead of the throw.
It's really tough to double up a guy with the speed that he has, and he was hustling all the way on this ground ball. So they should be happy they at least got the guy out at second. It'll be interesting now to see if he tries to use that speed again and swipe a bag and get into scoring position.
Runner at first here, one man out. Fouled away. The 1-2. And he fouls this one off. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. Now a throw over, and he'll dive back in safely. Runners on first with one down. And again a throw, and he'll get back in safely. Once more, a throw over, and a dive, but he's back in there. Working for the punch out and the offering. Pitch misses low. The throw down is not close as he's in there with a stolen base. So he swipes second successfully, but you have to wonder now if that might actually end up taking the bat out of the hands of one of their better hitters.
Well, that's a good point, Matt, but I'd be a little surprised if that's the case. It's still early and the game is tied, so that would be a pretty cautious move to pitch around him here or just walk him flat out.
McNeil will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning.
That is four. The right fielder, number two, Adam Eaton.
So a runner in scoring position with two men gone, and the next to bat, the speedy Adam Eaton. The 2-2. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
The payoff pitch. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Nationals leave one, and now the Mets offense will go to work for the first time. No score. Max Scherzer gets the starting assignment for the Nats in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be a fun one to watch. This guy's been around the block for a while, but he's having a rock-solid season with a real good ERA. It'll be really interesting to see how he attacks his opposing lineup.
Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's Scherzer now, 1-1. Scherzer is sitting on 170 wins in his career. Great production, especially in an era where wins are harder to come by. The 1-2. Hit hard up the middle, and a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning. The throw into second.
Batting second, the left fielder, number six.
So now to the plate, Jeff McNeil. And this will go right by Suzuki all the way to the backstop, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. No one out with a runner at second. Count still full, 3-2. Toward the alley in left center, and that gets down as he can't get there in time. The run is in to score, and they take an early 1-0 lead.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. Get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%, not trying to do too much, able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
To the plate now, Michael Conforto, skied in the air to straightaway left. Soto will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
Batting fourth, the second baseman, Robinson Cano.
Here comes the second baseman, Robinson Cano. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Has a look, now the pitch. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Here comes the payoff pitch. This is lined to left. In there, a base hit.
Wow, you rarely see this guy give up more than a hit an inning, and he's already given up three here. It's too early to be concerned, but you do have to keep an eye on him moving forward. He's a pro, though, so he's capable of turning things around in a hurry.
At the plate now, Wilson Ramos. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Right back to the mound. Could be an easy two. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Mets forced to settle for one here in the inning. We'll go on to the top of inning number two. It's the Mets one and the Nationals nothing. In now for Washington, Kurt Suzuki, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. In there, 2-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder is on the run. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
That is good. The second baseman, Wilmer Defoe.
Stepping into the box, Wilmer Defoe. The 1-1. We're in the second, 1-0 Mets early on. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
On the ground for Cano at second. He's right there, and there are two away now.
That is set. The third baseman, Jake Knoll.
Coming to the plate now, Jake Knoll. Hard hit ball to second. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And no chance at all to make a play here, so despite the effort, the inning will continue.
The first baseman, number 3, Michael A. Kuhl.
Standing in now, Michael Taylor. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1. These Mets fellas, as they take the field here today, they come in a real funk to start the year. Still searching for what's been an elusive first win.
Yeah, Matty, for me, I'm going to go off script here. I think one of the keys to winning this game, I get it. The pitcher has to throw strikes. The offense has to show up. But I need more energy, more focus. I need guys flying around. I need guys looking like they want to win a ball game.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Max Scherzer, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. ready with the 1-1. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Juan Soto would be next. Two men are on with two men out. Now a ball lifted high in the air towards shallow right center field. And Cano will make the catch to retire the side. Nats leave a pair. It remains 1-0. Next for the Mets, Amed Rosario. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. The 3-1. Turned on down the line. But this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. In the air to right center. Long run for the center fielder. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Batting seven, the third baseman, J.D. Davis.
So digging in now, J.D. Davis, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And that misses, 2-1. Fellas, the Nationals, as they take the field here today, they come in a real funk to start the year. Still searching for what's been an elusive first win.
Yeah, Matty, for me, I'm going to go off script here. I think one of the keys to winning this game, I get it, the pitcher has to throw strikes, the offense has to show up. But I need more energy, more focus. I need guys flying around. I need guys looking like they want to win a ball game.
Brandon Nimmo.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And ready to bat next, the Wyoming native Brandon Nimmo. Two out, nobody on. Nimmo with an even count of 2-2 now. And it's fouled away. Fouled off. Another try at 2-2. Skied into very shallow right. There to take it now is Eaton, and the inning is over. Mets go down 1-2-3. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Top of the third set to get underway. Juan Soto to the plate now. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Here now the 2-2.
You can't lose, boy.
Trey Turner is on deck. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Line to the right side. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Now that's the way you answer. They're down 1-0 already, but he laces a double and puts himself in the scoring position. That'll get the dugout fired up and excited to punch back.
At the plate, Trey Turner, 3-1 to the Nationals shortstop. Oh, he had a go at one there, but this is fouled off to the right as the count draws full. This is line to left. And that's in there. Base hit. And they'll get it in quickly. It's first and third now with nobody out.
Boy, there's a bullet base hit right there, but you have to hold there, D-Row, to make sure that gets down and isn't caught for a line drive double play.
Yeah, you have to play the game right there and respect the infield and respect the line drive. I know he wants to get a ribby for his buddy, but that's the way the game's played.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Runners are at first and third with none out. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And that is down for extra bases as this will get one home and maybe two.
The pitcher was spotting his pitches effectively until now, working the edges, painting the corners, but he left this one right over the plate and it cost him with an RBI extra base hit right there.
Into the box now, Adam Eaton. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
The 2-1 home. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder is on the run. He makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. And he will score as that run breaks the tie and makes this a 2-1 ball game.
That was a good controlled swing out of him there. And that's exactly what he was hoping to do. Get it into the outfield and pick up the RBI.
At the plate, Kurt Suzuki. Now the 1-1 pitch. Runner goes for third. Pitch outside. The throw not in time as the offline throw allows him to get in there easily. Now the 2-1 pitch. Bouncer to the left side. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third.
The batter number one. Second
and now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. In now, Wilmer Defoe. Hit out toward second. There's Cano to second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. So they pick up three runs on four hits. No errors and no one left on base. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Nationals 3 and the Mets 1. Next up from New York, Jacob DeGrom.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Turner gloves it. And that's out number one.
Up next to the bat, the first baseman, Alonso.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. Popped him up. Taylor has room in foul territory. Makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Now batting, number six.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now.
Two out lightning definitely applies to this offense. If this two hole hitter can get on, they could start something serious.
And another foul ball. Third inning here, 3-1 our score. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Mets. Score holds, it's 3-1. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And one thing he mentioned is how well they're doing at simply putting the ball in play. Our research team found that to this point in the game, they've only missed the ball on less than 5% of their swings. Major League average is closer to 25%. So to put it simply, their hand-eye coordination at the plate is second to none right now.
Thank you, Heidi. In now, Jake Knoll, as we begin the top of the fourth.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Lays off the slider that time, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
3-1 now as that misses down and in. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Line shot to first, and there's one away.
The first baseman, number three, Michael A. Taylor.
Digging in for his second at bat, Michael Taylor reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. The 1-1 home. Hit hard on the ground to the right, and that is through into right field for a single.
Dan, how hard is it to massage your way through such a deep lineup? I mean, even the 8-9 hole hitters are solid big league players.
You know, Mark, these days you're not seeing a lot of defensive specialists in the infield or outfield. If you're in that starting lineup these days, there's a pretty good job you can swing the bat.
Now a move over to first, a dive, but he's back. Into the box, Max Scherzer. 1-2 to the Nationals pitcher. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And hey, a strikeout always works too.
To the plate now, Juan Soto. A pitch out, the throw, and they'll nail him at second on a brilliant call to pitch out, and the inning is over. Another look at the throwdown that results in a third out on the bases. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth, but before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with the Mets manager to discuss his thoughts on his club's offense so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. At the plate, Michael Conforto. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Fouled away. Just hung in there on that one. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Waiting on deck here is Robinson Cano. On the ground to the right side. He's got it. He'll feed it to Scherzer, covering to record the out.
The batter number 24, second baseman, Robinson Cano.
Robinson Cano, the next to dig in. A base hit in his first trip. One run on three hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1.
Man, this guy has retired a whole slew right now. I think what he needs to do is just stay focused and keep attacking the game plan like he has up to this point, because everything he's done has worked.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Robles waits on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Scherzer into the windup. 2-1 on its way. 2-2 the count.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now. 3-2. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. Mets go down 1-2-3, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. To the top of the lineup, stepping in Juan Soto. He'll start off the fifth in this one. And it's 1-2. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. Now the pitch.
Count is 3-2.
What a great battle to start this inning. What a great job by the leadoff hitter.
He knows that this pitcher's starting to get up there in pitches. The manager's starting to get restless. Let's see if we can knock him out and get into that bullpen.
It's a swing and a high pop-up. The catch is made on the mound, and that's the first out.
Now batter, the shortstop, Trey Turner.
Now to the plate, Trey Turner, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. The 1-1 home.
Nope. I got 2-1 to count.
3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. 2-2 count. Here it comes. Again, he sends it out of play. Ready with another 2-2. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
I'll tell you, he's showing no signs of tiring right now. Still looks razor sharp from what I can tell, so I think he might last a while longer if he can keep this up.
At the plate now, Victor Robles. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Three runs, six hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Cano towards second. He's got it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Washington, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, so striding forward now, Amed Rosario. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Two balls and a strike to Amed Rosario.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with his slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
And he fouls this one off. The 2-2. J.D. Davis waits on deck. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. And a slider. Oh, got a favorable call on that one, as that's the first out of the inning.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
I know we want to focus on the offense and how bad they've been so far, but can we give some love to the pitcher? He has had these guys in the rocking chair all day.
And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on. Misses, ball two. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2. Line drive to center field. Robles is there, two gone.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
And And here's the former first round draft choice, Brandon Nimmo. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three and the inning is over. Pretty painless half of the inning all told. We're through five here at the ballpark. Washington leads this one 3-1. Walker Lockett is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season.
Walker Lockett.
So next will be the four hole for the Nationals. Adam Eaton comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Here it comes on 1-1. Lifted in the air out to left. There to make the catch is McNeil, and there's one away.
The catcher, number 28, Kurt Suzuki.
Now in the box, Kurt Suzuki, a hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Big swing, but a little dribbler here to the right side of the mound. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
Now batter, the second baseman, Wilmer Defoe.
And here now is Wilmer Defoe. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least. So you know he wants to make up for it right here.
Grounded back up the middle, and a good effort on the dive that time, but this will get by him for a base hit.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
So now to the plate, Jake Knoll. Lined but speared on a hop. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. One left for Washington as the lead remains 3-1. Jed Lowry is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six.
Lowry.
One and two now as that one's fouled off. Now here's the pitch. Slow little grounder left side. And there's one down now.
Now batting, the first baseman, Pete Alonso.
So here's Pete Alonso, 1-for-2, including a double back in the first. The 2-2. Takes this the other way to right. And that'll get by and on through towards the wall. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they can get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Runner at second, one away, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
He showed right there why having a good changeup is so valuable. Two and two, and he flips one up there that the bottom really falls out at the last minute. It's so hard to pick up, and it's even harder to make good contact with.
Into the box now, Michael Conforto. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
We're in the sixth inning here in a 3-1 ball game. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full. 3-2 here.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there. 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter on that one.
Drilled on the ground is short. Turner fields it cleanly. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Mets leave one. They still trail it here 3-1. Blake Taylor is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
For the New York Mets, number 62, Blake Taylor.
Seventh inning ready to roll. Digging in to try it again, Michael Taylor. He singled his last time up. Now a swing and a fly ball. And no one will track it down. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. And with strike three recorded there, he's notched his first career major league strikeout.
Well, Matt, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have at least one pitch that they can go into in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
And he lays off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. Ground ball right side. And that'll find its way into right field for a one-out single.
Hey, I've been impressed with this guy. Not only has he thrown the ball well, but now he's mixing in a base hit late in the game, giving his manager options. Whether or not he wants a pinch run, keep him in there, go to the relief. I mean, he's opened up a whole weaponry box for the manager.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. From the belt, the pitch.
Three balls, one strike.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Nimmo. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The batter, number 7, shortstop, Trey Turner.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and in the bat is Trey Turner. The 2-1 is taken for strike two. Working for the punch out and the offering. Swing and a liner. And that's in there. Base hit.
That was actually a well-executed fastball in to in off the plate. Credit the offensive player. He smelled that coming, turned and burned.
Big spot here. First and second, two men gone, and that'll bring up the outfielder Victor Robles. Two men are on with two men out. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, 1-2. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get into a worse situation with the cleanup guy up next.
Here now the 2-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. That's leave a pair, and it's still 3-1. Digging in once again, Robinson Cano. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
A ball and two strikes now. Hit in the air down the right field line, but this will wind up being a foul ball. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Lifted the other way down the left field line, but this will land untouched. Set to deal on 2-2. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Robles is right there, one down.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson Ramos.
And that'll bring up Wilson Ramos. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Here's Scherzer now, 1-1. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Hey, that's the modern game right now, north-south. Elevate that high fastball and bury stuff in the dirt. Completely different from the east-west we came up playing.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
So he sets him down swinging. Wilson Ramos becomes the second out of the bottom of the seventh. In now, Ahmed Rosario. 1-2 now. Bases are empty here with two men out. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. The next 1-2 pitch. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Down in order go the Mets. Score holds, it's 3-1. In now is Adam Eaton. He'll start us off in the eighth. Three-two pitch. Pulls this one into the air out into right field.
Conforto
is there, one away.
The catcher, number 28, Kurt Suzuki.
Stepping in, Kurt Suzuki. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Ah, gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, one and two. This one is launched. Look at this. Back goes McNeil. And that's a home run into the top tank. So a solo shot there from Kurt Suzuki. His first home run of the season as the Nationals move in front now 4-1. Certainly a home run worthy of show track, and we see here that ball was blasted off the bat at 116 miles an hour. The distance wasn't too shabby either. Stepping in now, Wilmer Defoe. Called strike two. Bases are empty, one man out. He stays alive, still two and two. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Up next for Washington.
Now batting, Jake Knoll. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 1-2. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Nationals able to add on thanks to the long ball. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth. It's now a 4-1 Washington lead. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Austin Voth will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Andrew Stevenson will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch.
Number 17.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. Ready for another shot now. J.D. Davis hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
A ball and two strikes now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. And there are the final numbers for the Washington starter. And he'll be very happy with how the day went.
One of the big keys to having a good pitching performance is not being afraid to throw the ball into the strike zone. And this guy certainly wasn't in this one. Didn't allow a walk all game long.
Trace Barrera has come into the ballgame now as he takes over as the new third baseman.
Barrera.
Standing in now, Brandon Nimmo. And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul.
He smoked that changeup foul. That's why we're seeing the expansion of netting around baseball.
And that misses two and two.
Got to find a way to scratch at least one across. You do not want to take on the monster closing the game down three.
Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
And he goes with the slider here as that misses in tight. It's ball four.
Well, when you go with the slider there on a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Yoenis Cespedes will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 52.
Line to the right side, and that'll get down for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
That's the difference in today's games. Pitchers will throw any pitch in any count, but the batter was able to deliver on a 3-2 breaking ball.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. Eighth inning, 4-1 is our score. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Down the third baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But this one will bend foul. Had plenty of distance, though, as it landed in the upper deck. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Robles waits on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. So here's Jeff McNeil, and with men on base and two away, it feels like this at bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit, but if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
Count remains full. The next 3-2. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Swung on and grounded to the second baseman Defoe. Scooped up on the first, and the Mets are going to come up empty here as that ends the inning. Two left for the Mets, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Paul Sewald enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one. So stepping in, Michael Taylor. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. He takes something off there as this is swung on and missed, and there's one gone here in the ninth.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
To the plate now, Trace Barrera. Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Nimmo is there now, and he has it, two gone.
The left fielder, number 22, Juan Soto.
So the Nats lineup turns over, and to the plate, Juan Soto. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
The 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. Here's another 1-2. Left side, but well foul. Two out, nobody on. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
Boy, that's a good pitch right there. The old school guys would call that a little bit of chin music up and in. See if he can get him to move off the box a little bit.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Pulled toward right center field. And now that'll hop over the wall. So he'll be at second here with two away on a ground rule double.
Pretty good swing right there as he drives this ball deep. One hops over the wall, and he could just walk into second base with a ground rule double.
Into the box, Trey Turner changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Good take there to lay off the high fastball. Two out here and a runner at second. A bouncer to the left side. Throw not in time, and he's in there with his third hit of the afternoon.
Boy, when things are good, things are going really good. How about a swinging bunt infield single right there for his third knock of the game, D-Row?
Yeah, he has to be feeling frisky right now. He's had two great at-bats, and then this one, he's 100% on fire. Getting an infield single for his third knock of the game, that's awesome.
3-1 to him now. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd. And he misses ball four.
Oh, that's a walk that could really change the complexion of the game. With the bases loaded, if he gives up a base hit right here, it could get real ugly.
Adam Eaton digging in next. And with every base occupied, a big hit here could really put this one out of reach. One and two now to Adam Eaton.
Count one and two.
Two out, bases loaded. And a slider gets away from him here as it just about got him in the ankle.
We can't hear it from here, obviously, but I think someone in the dugout just yelled, "Wear it," because that could have been a run.
High and deep to right. Gone! It's a grand slam. So he will touch them all on the grand slam. His first home run of the season, as this is now a 7-run ball game.
They were so close to getting out of this mess. Two outs, two strikes, but then the grand slam gave him something he could handle, and he pays for it dearly.
Jerry's familiar. Enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
Jerry Familia.
So now to the plate, Kurt Suzuki. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. But the damage in the inning came right here for the Nationals, a grand slam home run. Last chance coming up here for the Metropolitans. It's the Nationals 8 and the Mets 1. Digging in, Michael Conforto. He was a ground out victim last time up. Now the 2-1.
The count is 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Robles waits on it. One down.
The batter. The second baseman, Robinson Cano.
And next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Robinson Cano. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 2-1 home. One out, nobody on. Popped him up. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson Ramos.
Mets down to their final out now. And next is the catcher, Wilson Ramos. Hard liner toward short, and that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
In now, Amed Rosario. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. And he popped him up. Barrera in foul ground. And no one will track it down. Two out with the man at first. Fastball is outside. It's full now. 3-2.
3-2. Two out. Runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now a swing and a fly ball. And this should do it. And he will make the catch to wrap this one up, and the Nationals are in the win column for the first time this year as the ball game is over.
Well, just an excellent job right here closing this one out. He just collected the first save of his career. Gotta start somewhere.
8-1 is the final score this afternoon. Washington led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Max Scherzer earns his first win of the season. Austin Voth works two full innings in relief to record the save, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.